like Donkey Kong, man.
Oh my God! Oh my gosh! Tarpon! Tarpon!
Tarpon! Tarpon! Tarpon! Oh my gosh!
Holy crap!
Did you see that? Oh my! What? Oh my gosh! Okay, now we're talking, boys.
Holy crap!
Now we're talking. Serious.
That was huge, man.
That was. Hey, I know. That was knocking on 100. I'm so scared right now. This would be a life changer right here. Oh, fish! Fish on! Fish I don't on. Know what it is, but it's alive.
Fish on, here we go.
It's not a cuda, yeah, or it's not a tarpon, but it's alive.
It's a
big snook.
It's a snook.
Oh my gosh, a big, nice, snook, really snook. Nice snook.
All right, where's that hook thing?
I got it on me. Really nice snook, like big class snook.
I think you can safely touch though.
Yeah, I think they, wow, right in the mud here, that is crazy. So we got all this current going with the wind. Look at that, look at them. Oh my gosh. Look at the fish feeding out there.
On a musky glide bait.
Yeah, come here, buddy. This is my first snook ever. Come I haven't on. Got it yet, but that's okay. I just wanna.
Dang.
Wow.
Here you go. Here you go. He's hooked good. Open up, open up. Open up. Open up. Open up. He's up.
Nice work, buddy. Can I lift this thing?
Maybe.
Yeah, I got it. I'm good. Okay. That is cool. I got her.
You got it?
Yep.
Awesome.
Look at that. First snook ever in my life. On a musky glide bait. I didn't want to hurt her. We're all good. Look, another tarpon just went.
Oh my gosh. Here's your rod.
Dude, thanks, Robbie. Oh my gosh. Everything is going bananas.
There you go.
We're on a falling tide right now. Everything is just going cuckoo out here. I cannot wait to get my bait back in the water. Oh, he rolled on it. I had him hit it. That close. He touched the bait. I felt him tick it. Oh my gosh. Thing is, you could put one of these fish you see jumping all around on, and you could probably hook up with one. But I just want to do it on artificial. Oh, look, look. Oh, man.
Holy crap.
Probably easier to catch when there's less bait.
I don't know what more you can ask for. Having live bait.
Yeah. Oh!
What is happening?
Listen.
Got one! Hooked on! Hooked! Got him?
Got him! Got him!
Nice.
Got him!
Nice.
Got him!
Good job, Robbie!
Got him.
Nice!
Holy crap! Oh, I hope we have enough line. He's a big one too.
Let him go.
He's tough, man.
Oh, please.
My finger hurts. It is just going, man. Oh, gosh. It's going straight out there. Oh, what do we do? All right, he's finally done.
Okay.
We have plenty of line left.
Okay, good.
Look at this run. Oh.
Plenty of line left. I think you spoke too soon.
I think he's still going.
Dude, I'm getting a hoagie.
He's so far out there. Yep, that was him way out there, man. Oh my goodness. I don't know. Ah, gosh. There's nothing I can do. There's nothing I can do. Drag is locked down. Drag is locked down. He's literally, I don't know how many yards that is, but I can finally make some gain. I can finally gain right now. Woo! Come on. if we land, I mean, this is just, he's so far out there. We will see, we will see. Plenty of light left. He's off.
What?
Off.
No!
Yeah, that's what tarpon do. Just head shaking like crazy.
Do you still have a bait?
We'll see. I have to reel in a lot of line. Oh, that sucks.
That was wild.
That sucks. I don't know what you can do from shore.
How do you get on?
He must have, I think I still have bait, so. Just the nature of the game with tarpon. You don't land very many. Oh.
Let's just say that was one of the most incredible nights of fishing ever. I mean, wow. Wow. Wow.
Did you guys see that?
How did we stumble into that feeding frenzy of, what is that?
I don't know. That was, I don't even, that happened.
Yeah, yeah, I'm just so happy we had cameras running because I don't think people would believe us that literally a tarpon frenzy was happening right in front of our very eyes.
Right, but right
at our feet.
At our feet.
Yeah, yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
Literally, they were feeding 8 feet from our feet at point.
Incredible.
I mean, it's just incredible.
That day we picked up our editor, Andrew Natvig, and let's just say he got a warm welcome to the ocean.
Yeah.
I mean, the first night he's ever like really in the ocean seeing us fish. I mean, because he doesn't fish at all.
And yeah, he has no idea what's happening out there.
And he's like, oh, is this like a normal night? No, absolutely not.
Yeah, there's 150-pound fish jumping all around us. And he's like, wow, man,
this is cool.
This is pretty great.
And yeah, so that was pretty funny.
Now, if that doesn't get you jacked up wanting to go do something like that,
yeah.
I mean, then you're dead in your own skin.
Yes.
Because that is just as amazing
incredible
as it gets.
Yeah.
You know, as basically a saltwater beginner,
yeah.
I mean, it really, I mean, granted, it was so fun, so exciting, but truly was heartbreak station over and over.
We're at day 11 here, and it's just incredible how many fish we have lost so far. It's just, we just can't get it done.
We're not good at it.
We just can't touch, yeah. I mean, like, during that fight, I mean, I wasn't bowing to the king, like some of the, I don't know.
You can't even mentally get
that
far.
Right.
It's so intense.
Yeah, definitely some mistakes there. Probably had the drag too tight, maybe. I don't know. But all I know, there was a giant, giant fish at the end of my line way out in the ocean. It was incredible. It was jumping way out there. I don't even know if it was possible to land those fish. I don't know.
I don't
know if we could have.
We didn't get the chance that night, unfortunately.
Yep.
You know, with all those fish around too, we really only had
one
really good strike
on
that hoagie jerkbait.
Yep.
And
I don't get
you
it.
Would think. I mean, they're just so tuned into those mullet like that.
Yeah.
I mean, you could see schools of mullet just flying every which way.
Yeah.
I don't know how you can actually top an experience like that
other
than getting one in your hands.
Right. I mean, just seeing those things just fly out of the water for those mullet, I mean, that was just cool enough. It was like topwater strikes, but yet not on your line.
Oh, it was truly in the top three fishing experiences of my entire life, without a doubt.
So insane.
How about you?
It's up there. It is up there. Hopefully we can go there and have that happen again, but I think it'll never be that cool.
I don't know. Never say never.
That's true.
You know, incidentally, that's where I caught my first really big barracuda was right there from that same exact spot.
Yep.
And caught other ones since then.
So
it's obviously a good spot. We're going to have to revisit.
Yeah, maybe next year. So, guys, thank you so much for watching this truly incredible memory that Lee and I have. And it's just, it's so cool we got it on camera. So, thanks again, guys.
See you next episode.
Yep, see you next time. And I don't know why I'm still talking.
Uh...